welcome to Money, 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 your weekly personal finance date with me, Surabhi Upadhyay. This is our very first date of 2019, which is why I've decided to take you out. First of all, here's wishing a very happy new year to all of our viewers out there. Now, where am I taking you out? To one of the top mutual fund houses of this country. We are here at the headquarters of Reliance Mutual Fund to find out just how the men who manage money here really think. If you are already an investor with them, or if you're thinking of putting some money in some of the Reliance funds, then the questions that will be on your mind: debt, equity, should you look at fixed income, mid caps, small caps, market volatility, interest rates. All of that is going to be covered in our conversation. Let's go and find out how the bosses who run this place really think when it comes to 2019. Hi, Sandeep.
Hi.
Thank you for having us over to your office. Thank you very much. Season's greetings. Wish you a very, very happy new year. Happy 2019.
Wishing all your viewers also very, very happy new year.
Thank you very much. Now, first of all, do you make new year resolutions? Do you have something in mind for you?
Yeah, of course. I think how do we ensure, we increase the financial inclusion. I think we have to ensure every mutual fund, every Indian investor is investing in mutual funds. We need to get more people coming to the mutual fund industry. That's the resolution for us.
So those are the politically correct answers. We'll get to, you know, his real resolutions a little later on the show. But, you know, it's good to be here. 2018 was a little more challenging. It wasn't a straight, simple ride.
It was very challenging.
I'm sure for you and, you know, your colleagues who actually manage money here. And also for investors, it tested patience. We had to realize that we'll also see losses in our funds. I mean, a lot of the funds are actually negative. Some of the best performing funds are also sort of down, you know, 5, 10, 15%. Now, first of all, if you look back at 2018, have there been any lessons for investors that are parking money in your funds? And then how do you take it forward in 2019?
Well, it's a very interesting. 2018 was one of the most challenging years. Mm-hmm. If you were to look at it, whether to debt, equity, on for all parameters, all asset classes, it was very difficult. Especially when we see, mm-hmm. I think investors walked into 2018 very positive, getting huge returns, you know, over the last few years.
Yes.
But effectively, the negative returns in large cap funds,
yes.
Almost negative, huge negative returns in small cap.
Yes.
But I think the key learnings have been, you know, if you were to look at it from a long-term point of view, mm-hmm. this volatility is always going to be there. Mm. I mean, in spite of the fact today, let's take large cap are almost, you know, zero return. Mid cap is about minus 10 to 15% return.
The best performing funds are, which are down only 10%.
But I think the key learning in this is if you were to look, extend this beyond 1 year, I mean, you look at over the 5 year, 10 year period, again, the same funds are giving an average CAGR return of 15%.
Yeah.
Small cap are giving a return of about 18 to 20%. And that's the way I think the investors have to understand, and that from in equities are going to have volatility.
It really hit me when I started doing some basic research to talk to you guys. Simple throwback tells you that it's actually been a great year for ETFs. If you hadn't put money in active managed funds, if you simply went with one of the ETFs, a Sensex ETF, or some of the smart beta products, right? The NV20 index, even you guys have that product as well. So some of these products have actually done better. So is this also a year of learning? Because we never typically would speak of ETFs when it came to retail money earlier. So is that also changing?
I'm very happy, you know, for us. I think we've always seen ETF as a very big opportunity.
Because of the CPSE ETF as well.
The way we see from a long-term point of view, I think investors will always have to be given a choice.
Mm.
I think there will be investors who will like to go for active funds.
Mm.
There will be investors who will like to go for ETF.
Okay.
But this was the first year which actually where the ETFs have taken the center stage.
Absolutely.
And you're right. I think I've always been saying this over the last many years that I think clearly from a large cap funds point of view,
mm-hmm.
I think because the large cap funds have an expense of a 200 basis point,
right.
You will see from a long-term point of view, it will become more and more difficult for large cap funds, active large cap funds, to create the kind of alpha they've been creating, and that's where ETFs are going to challenge them.
Fair enough. You know, why 2019 is also very interesting, because besides the market volatility, this is going to be a year when your industry is going through a massive change. The way in which mutual funds are sold, the distribution model, the intermediary advisory model, all of that, a lot of changes are happening. Trail commissions, which is what the regulator has now mandated, nothing upfront, all trail. So just purely from a sales point of view and from a customer experience point of view, what will 2019 throw up?
No, I think I'll just take it this way. I think as we talk today, I mean, we 2018, we saw a lot of changes. But whenever we see changes, we try to, you know, think, and these are big changes. It's going to change the world. In 2009, we saw the loads going away. A lot of changes keep happening. Maybe when we do this show in 2029, you'll see, you won't even remember these changes. And anything that is good for the investor in long run is good for the industry. Okay. I think I clearly believe whatever changes are happening place, I think the industry will have to transition. Industry will have to move, you know, aligned to these changes. Sure. And I think it's very important that the entire industry, all asset managers, all distributors, all advisors have to start seeing and pushing what is good for the investor. And as long as that is done, I clearly see today in India, 2% of the population is investing in mutual funds and ETF. Clearly it's a long way to go.
Sure, there's enough potential. There's no denying that. But let me ask you this again, more hard questions, right? Because 2018, the mutual fund industry also came into the limelight for a lot of other reasons. You know, we had the whole NBFC issue spiral out. And then even retail investors were asking that, you know, bhai, hamara paisa ultimately, where is it getting invested, right? What is the underlying, is there a problem? Is there a problem with my debt funds? You know, what's going on? Is my money being used to lend to certain entities? All legal, perfectly legal. But these questions started coming up, and not just in pink papers, in mainstream, you know, regular newspapers as well. So how do you look at some of these challenges?
No, I think it's that's a price you pay, I think, when you're coming to the center stage. Yeah. Everything is under the scanner all the time. Mm-hmm. But I think the way you have to see this is, I think for the retail investor, there are two key messages in it. Mm-hmm. I think it's not, whenever you invest, there's going to be some return. There's going to be volatility and there's going to be risk associated with it. Mm-hmm. Typically what happens, especially before 2018, in between 2014 and 2017, investors have started thinking mutual funds can only give positive returns, great returns, and there is no risk attached to it. I mean, I think, again, especially this was even more of feeling in debt because I think the yields were moving in one way. Yeah. This is a very interesting year. Last year, 2018, the 10-year started at 7.30, went all the way 8 plus, came down again to 7.30, and this, all these credit fears which were there, you know.
Absolutely.
So I think the way I see is that the advice for the retail investors, it's very important not to get carried away with the returns, also to see the risk appetite they have, number one, and also the research capability. There's a very old saying, you know, the more due diligence to do, the more luckier you get. So I think it's important to understand, for investors need to understand, fixed income will also have risk.
Absolutely. Fixed income is not a fixed deposit. We have been saying that on Money throughout the year. It's not a fixed deposit. There's a difference. Please be careful. That's one of the most important learnings from 2018. You need to do your homework. These are securities that trade in the market. You need to sit with your financial advisor and ask all the right questions before you put your money, even in fixed income. It's not fixed returns. Anyway, we will take a very quick break on that note. So Sandeep stays right here with us. What we'll do is we start off with the first love for many people. It's equities at the end of the day. So we'll bring in Manish Gunwani, the man who manages all the equity money here at Reliance Mutual Fund. We'll find out what he feels about 2019. Back in a moment.